Hi, this video is part of a four-part VPS video course that covers why you should be using a VPS, creating a VPS and signing in, loading your MetaTrader platform and robots into your VPS, and creating portfolios up to 32 MetaTrader accounts. Please make sure that you watch these videos in sequence. Now, I'm going to show you very quickly how to now replicate this whole process. How you do that is you go into the Windows platform to get to the program files, and you go into the program files and there you see MetaTrader IG1. Now that is the one that we want to replicate. So what we do is we just say copy and we say paste. So what happens, it makes a copy of that file, and then what we do is we rename it. We go and we say IG2. So that is now a IG2, and I open that file and I take the terminal and I again send the terminal to the desktop, and there it's appeared on the desktop. So I close this, no longer needed, and I'm going to open this terminal. So the first thing I do is I rename the icon there, and that is going to be IG2. So that's IG2. And here is IG2, and I'll just open it up properly, and there it is. That's how we want it. So what we do, the same process. This time I'm going to trade the euro. I'm going to close everything I don't need, get rid of that indicator, delete indicator, and then we'll go into what I need to do is load the profit retriever into this platform. So I'll go to it was in downloads, and I go into profit retriever and I say okay, I want to go into IG1 now. There's IG2, just do all of them again, install to all. That's the button that installs it to all the instances, so that's actually very good. And we go next, and it says yes. Now sometimes it won't install if there's an open platform, so that is why it's good. So we say exit. It's good that you've seen this. I'm actually going to close this platform, and that one already has it, so it should now install into it. So we go back to downloads, we go like that, we go next again, and I'll be very specific this time. I'll go to 2 and next and install. See, now it's happy because I've closed the platform, and I say refresh and go, and now we can open this one and see what happens. Okay, and we then, and there's the profit retriever. I'll just drag it onto the screen. We say we want to allow live trading. We want to allow dills, and that's okay. We're going to stick with that one. And there we are. What we can also now do is delete all the symbols that we don't need. So I'll go hide all, and now we only have the euro. So I basically have this platform set up. I need to go and change the name. So I go in here and I save the profile as IG2. And we say OK. So the profile is now IG2. I can minimize this. Oh, I can't. So I'll have to minimize it like I used to before. Close it manually and do this. Okay, so essentially what we now have is we have two platforms that we can trade. By just clicking on auto trading, we can actually trade these platforms. So at this point, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open as many platforms as I can to see what the capacity of this VPS service is. Now, I won't bore you by doing everything in front of you again. You have seen how I make copies of the previous platforms, and That is how you do it. And I'm just going to be repeating that same process over and over again until I reach the capacity of this VPS service. But before I leave you, I will be back. I will restart the video when I'm finished with that process. Before I leave you, one of the things you need to do now, we have our icons there. What we do is you close the platforms manually. You close them manually, and then you open them manually. Like that. And the reason why you do that is that MetaTrader has a restore point, and by closing them manually, you create a restore point, and by opening them, then that confirms that restore point. And what happens is if you by chance, by accident, lose any of these platforms, then you've got a restore point for them. If, for instance, you refresh the whole platform, you could lose a lot of those settings. So this prevents you from losing the setting. Also, it will restore whenever you click on that, it will restore these platforms back to their normal places. Okay, so I'll see you soon after I've opened the balance of the... Okay, back again. It's been about 10 hours since I stopped the video, and I have added in those 10 hours 24 trading platforms to the VPS, and they actually traded through the American market. So they were actively traded, the profit retriever EA was traded, and on your screen you can see the CPU usage and the memory currently being experienced. The market is still open, and you can see only 43% of the memory is used at the moment and only 30% of the CPU. So this VPN has actually managed quite amazingly well, considering we are using the smallest package offered by Contabio, which is the 4 cores and 8 gigs of RAM. So if you are concerned about resources, another $5 will basically almost double the resources, so you won't have to worry. But as shown already, 24 platforms running at very low capacity in terms of the resources applied. And I'm just going to run through these 24 platforms just to show you that they are trading and that they've done reasonably well over that period. So here we go there, and all you need to look at is the balance figure. There are open trades, but the balance figure has been nicely positive in most cases. There you are, small one. Oh, that's a very small one. Small. Anyway, just to show you that trading has occurred and run for about 10 hours during this process. Here's one, but it is trading. Not much happening on this particular currency. Oz, New Zealand, sideways currency. And there we go. A lot of open trades there. Okay. Right. Just flip through, and that's what I like about the system. I can flip through and see the results pretty easily. I know exactly which account is being traded because I just look at the numbers shown on the profile names. So there we are, there are the 24 accounts running at very low capacity. I could most probably now add another 6 quite safely. MetaTrader has a 32 platform hard coded limitation on one computer. You can't go more than 32 open platforms, but 24 is a nice manageable amount. And I also like having the icons for all of the platforms on the screen here. If I close all of those platforms, I can reopen them very quickly. And in fact, let me do that, because that is a good practice. Even while they're trading live, you can do this, and you can just close them all, and I'm going to do that. This is a very good practice. You should do it quite often. It reboots the platform, gets rid of saved history, and that clogs the system. And then all you do is you click on the actual icons and they'll all come back in their positions that they were before. Missing one there, number 12. Missing one there, number 9. Let's see, and that's number 16. Right, so they're all back in trading again. I'll just tidy them up again. Quickly. Okay, that so part of the video's purpose was to show you that you could set up a sizable portfolio of trading accounts using a very inexpensive VPS service, and that the resources need not be a limitation on the number of platforms that you open. So now we're going to look at something else. If we look at the trading at the moment, you'll see that there is no FX Blue link to this, and you need an FX Blue link to firstly analyze the accounts, but also create a platform where you can then, rather than dialing into your VPN, and just control it via a portfolio management system. Now I'm going to show you a little bit about that. In order to explain what I'm going to be doing now is we need to look at a previous slide that I used, and there are two methods of linking to FX Blue. The one method is by putting a robot on your trading platform, and the robot will then submit the trading to FX Blue. And that basically, there we are, that is the VPS that we've just been looking at. You would then put the robot on the VPS and it would transmit details to FX Blue. The problem with that one is that it gobbles up resources. In other words, you're adding another robot, and in my case you would have added 24 robots into that system, and it would just gobble up resources. So there's another way of linking to FX Blue, and that is what they call the sync method. Now the sync method doesn't go close to the VPN at all. It goes straight to the broker's server. It says, okay, let's look at the account as it's shown by the in the broker's server. So therefore your resources are liberated from this area and moved to that area. And I'm going to just quickly show you that on a typical FX Blue account. Okay, and here we are on FX Blue. The link to this will be in the description of the video as well as in the commentary of the video, but it's very easy. It's fxblue.com, and here we are. And what you do when you link your account, you go to FX Blue Live, and there we are. Now here are the two methods that you can use. And in this instance I'm using MT4. You can use the sync method, or you can use the publisher method. The publisher method requires you to download the robot, put it on your platform, and it will send the message to FX Blue. The other way is to use an account sync method, which is gives FX Blue the right to access your account on the broker server. But don't worry, the FX Blue cannot impact your account because you're going to be using the investor code. So just going to click here, and all you do is you add the broker server information, the account number, and the read only code, which is the investor code. That's all you do, and you then supply the email for your account. Those four steps, once you've done those four steps, FX Blue will go and fetch the information from the broker server, and you will then have an FX Blue account. So that is another tip that I have for conserving your resources on your VPS. Don't link FX Blue via the publisher, link it through the account sync method. Now, I sincerely hope that you've learned a lot from this series of using VPS facilities for your Forex trading. If you have any questions, comments, or remarks, please use the YouTube commentary facility, and I will respond to any questions or comments made in YouTube. Also, please let me know of any other information that you are missing, and I will make another video about that aspect. But the intention here was to show you that for very minimum amount of money, you can open a VPN facility and trade a nice big portfolio of robots. And I won't go into the portfolio benefits, but essentially I use portfolios to balance my risk. As you've seen, as we went through the balances there are some that are battling and some that are doing well and so on. So over time, the 24 accounts will start balancing each other out. Some will go through drawdown phases, some will go through successful phases, and then they'll reverse their roles. Then the others will go through drawdowns and the others will be successful. So over time, the longer you trade a portfolio, the more successful you get. The other thing is I'm using a very secure and robust robot, the Profit Retriever, and that has some really robust settings that will work 90% of the time or 95% of the time. And if you make those settings even more conservative, you can get that to 97% of the time. So also you need to find a very robust trading system, either manual system or robot system for this kind of activity. Obviously you won't use a manual system on a VPN. They are ideal for robot trading. Ideally, you should use VPNs for live trading. You should not use them for trying to optimize your systems. The resources are limited for optimization. Optimization eats a lot of resources, needs a lot of storage, that type of thing. So rather do that on your own local computer and use VPS services for pure trading, as you've seen me do. Just a reminder again that, as you can see, the resources used by these 24 trading accounts is very low. I could most probably add a few there, and that's another reason for this video, is to say that if you set yourself up correctly, if you delete all of those currencies that you're not trading out of the system, and you keep the VPS purely for trading, as I've done here, you can actually run a very efficient trading system based on the resources that are provided by the smallest package by this VPS provider. So from me, Alex Deploy, cheerio.